Yeah, that wasn't really my best acting, was it? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and it is Copycat Friday. This week, we were inspired by the new Blade Runner film. If you haven't seen the film yet, make sure that you do. Cinematography in that film is amazing. Now, the Blade Runner's girlfriend Joy is actually a hologram in the film. Now, you don't really see it in the trailer that much, but in the film, Joy would often walk through him, which is not so crazy knowing that she's a hologram. Now, in the beginning of the intro, you saw me pressing a Sci-Fi interface, and this was created with Interface, a video pack from Rocketstock, who are sponsoring today's episode. With a collection of more than 400 elements, it's a simple matter of dragging the visuals you want to create a unique display, interface, and more. Visit the first link in the description below to find out more. So here's how to create your own hologram inside Premiere Pro. And just like many visual effects are done, we're going to blend different layers of video together. And to make it ourselves easy, place your camera on a tripod. The first layer that we need is an empty shot. This will be our base layer or background. Now keep your camera rolling so that your second shot is exactly the same. Film yourself against a green screen and pretend there's a hologram going through you. We're using a portable green screen here, which I'll put a link to in the description below as well. Now this here is your second video layer. We're going to film one more, which is the hologram. Again, from the same camera standpoint, film yourself or someone else that pretends to be a hologram. Then bring everything inside Premiere Pro and put the three video layers you filmed on top of each other. The empty shot goes on the bottom, the real person on the fourth video layer, and you'll see why we're doing this later on. And then finally, the hologram goes onto the third layer. Now we've been using a green screen, so let's start with keying that out. First off, I draw a mask on the inside of the green screen. Then take the ultra key effect to select the green and get rid of that. I'm going quickly over this process as it's something that we've shown many times on the channel. If you'd like to see an in-depth tutorial on how to pull a perfect green screen, you can click in the cards up there. Now I do the same process with the hologram clip, and that will leave us with two keyed out talents, which is very convenient to work with now. Next up, align the clip so that the timing of Kim's arm passing through me is correct. If needed, you can change the position of your talons here a little as well. Kim, the hologram, sits behind me, but your arm will eventually come in front of me. So I'll make a duplication of Kim by holding down the Alt key and dragging it to channel number 6. From this duplication, we remove the mask that we initially created for the green key. We do this because we'll create a new mask that is a lot smaller and only sits around the part of her arm. Now this mask will also animate from the mask bat's property, and just as her arm goes through my chest, we increase that mask to reveal it. And at the same time, we'll also track the edge of the mask with the position of my chest. Now when I move a little forward, we need to reposition the mask too. Now continue doing this until the mask has been animated properly, and you might need to tweak it here and there to get it all right. Now finally, you could increase the feather of that mask a little as well. So this is the basic setup, but to make Kim look more like a real hologram, we're going to add some lighting glitches on her. The glitch effect consists out of two layers. So first up, we'll duplicate the bottom hologram layer. Again, hold down the Alt key and drag it to the channel below. To see what we're doing, I disable the first hologram layer above. Then from the Lumetric color window, I'm going to add a little blue into it. And you could use the temperature slider for this. Finally, change the blending mode of that clip to color dodge. Now, this option can be found under the opacity property. If the glow seems to be too hard here, decrease the opacity a little for that layer too. Now let's enable the top layer again, and if we would play around with its opacity now, you can reveal that blue layer below. You can animate the opacity of that top layer so that it blinks here and there, revealing that light blue layer. It's nice to have it blink on the moment that she pushes her arm through me. And when that is done, we need to duplicate the effect to the second hologram clip, which is the arm of Kim. Now like before, duplicate the arm clip to the layer below. And now simply copy the original effect and paste it onto the arm clip. Since we couldn't copy the opacity because of the mask, I'll have to manually change the blending mode here to color dodge. And that's all it takes to get a virtual girlfriend. As a final touch, I'm selecting all of the clips in my timeline, right-clicking on it and say nest. And this will group all of those layers on which I'll add a fake camera movement to make it more dynamic and get rid of that static tripod shot. Now I'm using the presets from Jarl, which I'll also leave a link to in the description below. Thank you all so much for watching. And as always, stay creative. we have Think Tank, Manfrotto, Sectler, Lowpro, and Tenba. And you don't know what I'm thinking about here, guys? The ultimate camera bag comparison. So make sure to subscribe to stay tuned for this awesome video that will come very soon.